Hello everyone and welcome to BHASVIC and welcome to this student digital induction session. I'm Mark, the assistant principal for digital and communication. I'm really excited that you could join us today. This video will guide you through all the digital tools that you will need to make your start here smooth and successful. And like with a new job or any college, there's always new systems and tools to get to know. Now, most of you will have used Google tools such as Google Classroom and Google Drive in your previous schools. Some of you might have used Microsoft tools such as Teams, OneDrive and Outlook. Here at BHASVIC, we are a Microsoft college. And that means that most of the tools you will use for your day-to-day life here are from Microsoft. So in this session, we make sure you know what these tools are, how to use them, so that you can make the most of your studies here at BHASVIC. Now, if at any point I go too fast, you can always pause, rewind, and watch again. This video will also always be available here on the BHASVIC YouTube channel for you to come back to at any time. Now, before we go any further, you'll need to try out what you learn in this session. You can't just sit there, watch it, and move on. The quicker you get into good habits, know your way around our systems, and get hands-on with them, the quicker you can get on with the business of learning. Your form tutor over the coming weeks will set you a few assignments for you to demonstrate what you've learned in these sessions. This video and the follow-up tasks all form part of your timetabled hours, so make sure you get it done as soon as possible, and then you can just crack on with your lessons. So, let's dive in. So in your first 2 weeks, you'll need to get familiar with Microsoft Teams, Microsoft SharePoint, Microsoft OneDrive, and our own app, myBHASVIC. These tools will help you stay on top of your assignments, communicate with your teachers, and also keep you organized. But first, before all of that, you need to make sure you can sign into your Microsoft account. Now, we have prepared a separate video for that in which we show you how to sign in as well as set up two-factor authentication. This is when you use your username and your password as well as a code generated from an app. This prevents someone else getting into your account even if they have your password. You can find the link to the video in the description below and also here on screen. Now, let's have a look at what we're going to cover in this session. So the tools we're looking at are Microsoft Teams, SharePoint, OneDrive, and myBHASVIC app. We will go through the basics of these tools. If you want more detail about other features, then you can find more videos linked below, which show you additional features as well as other tutorials like how to connect your device to the college Wi-Fi. First up is Microsoft Teams. This is your go-to platform for checking assignments, submitting your work, and communicating with your teachers. You can access Teams via an app on your computer and on your phone, as well as visiting teams.microsoft.com. In these tutorials, we'll be showing a computer view and a phone view. So if it looks a little bit different for you on your phone or your computer, don't worry, it's all pretty much the same across every platform. Let's take a look. So here we are in Teams. On the left sidebar, you'll see lots of important tabs. At the top, the activity stream is where you'll find all notifications such as assignment updates or messages. And you can see here, those in bold haven't been read and those that are not in bold, I have read. You've then got the chat tab where you can then see private or group messages. The assignments tab lists all your current and past assignments. You can see them all listed here. The Teams tab shows all the groups and classes that you're in, hence the name Teams. You may also have the calendar button, which allows you to see your lesson schedule. So here we are in the assignments tab, and we can see along the top here, forthcoming, past due and completed. And Teams right now is telling me that I have some assignments that are overdue and I can click on those and see which ones those are. I can see the next assignments coming up. So I have something due on the 13th of August, the 14th of August, and then something further afield on the 6th of September. Now, it is possible by going to the filter button at the top right to also filter by different classes. Now, let's have a look at what it looks like inside one of the assignments. So I'm going to click on this one here, the general strike, reasons for failure. and I can see the instructions that my teacher has given me, and then when it's due at the top. I can then also see there has been some resources added to this. You can simply click on and it will open up within Teams, and you don't need to download it or jump out anywhere else. So if I click on this PowerPoint, it will open up in my screen and I can have a look at that and that resource and flip through. Then when I'm done, I can click on close and it brings me back into Teams. Now I've read all of it, I've completed my work, and you have some options now. So you can either go down to the bottom and say attach, and you can add a document that you have created. You might have written a Word document, you might have created a PowerPoint presentation, and you can collect and hand in documents you have saved in your OneDrive, something with a link. You might have a document where you can share it by a URL, something that's saved within Teams, or you can also upload directly from your computer. Now, if you've not started something new, there's also the option of using the new button, which lets you start from scratch, creating a new Word document, spreadsheet, presentation, a notebook page, a new feature allowing you to actually record a video or a Microsoft whiteboard. Then once you've done that, you can then simply go up to the button that says hand in. In this case, it's saying hand in late because the deadline was a couple of hours ago. And it will then ask me if I want to hand it in. And I'm saying, okay, hand in. And there we go. I've now submitted that. Now, if I realize I've made a mistake and I want to submit something that I didn't attach to it, I can simply go back and do undo hand in. And that allows me then to go back, attach a document, and hand it back in again. Now, if you find reading some of the content difficult or accessing it, then you'll find up here there is the Microsoft Accessibility Reader. So there you have it. That is assignments on Microsoft Teams. Activity tab is where you'll see all notifications. This includes mentions, replies, and assignment updates. Click on any notification to see more details. On the mobile app, tap the activity icon at the bottom of your screen to view your notifications. You'll find different types of notifications here. For example, if a teacher mentions you in a post, you'll see it here. Stay on top of your notifications to keep updated. The chat tab is for direct messages. You can chat one-on-one with teachers or classmates or create group chats. On the mobile app, tap the chat icon to start chatting. To start a new chat, click or tap on the new chat icon and type your recipient's name in the box and start your conversation. Now, if you're in the middle of a conversation and you want to specifically mention someone, like lots of other apps, you start with an at symbol, and then it will actually notify that person specifically that you have mentioned them in the conversation. You can also add other things to the chat, including formatting and reactions and emojis, keep it professional, as well as adding files and other particular things. Channels are where class discussions happen. Each team or class has channels dedicated to different topics. For example, you might have a general channel for overall class discussions and specific channels for assignments or projects. On the mobile app, the Teams icon is where you'll find the channels. So here I'm going to click on this class and I can now see the two different channels in here. To post in a channel, select the channel, click Start a New Post, write my message, and then I click Post. And remember, if I want to mention someone specifically, I can then just click at and get their name, and my message will pop up also in their activity feed. Let's explore SharePoint. SharePoint is basically a file sharing system for Teams. For your own files, you have OneDrive, and for Teams and groups, you have SharePoint. So a lot of it looks the same, but some might also have some fancy layout and design too. Now, you can find SharePoint in a few ways. You can find it from the Intranet tab in Teams, and also in some of your classes, there may be a tab along the top that you can find SharePoint there. At the top left of SharePoint, you will see what's called the mega menu. And this menu will be different for you compared to your friends and your teachers based on the subjects and courses that you're doing. And you'll have under your My Subjects a list of the subjects and courses that you have. So I'm going to click through one of those, and that will take me to a landing page, which then has information for my course. So here I can see my teachers have set up a folder for all students in first year, all students in second year, and then some useful tabs on the side. So some biology subject resources, a link to the subject resource guides in the library as well. So if I click through into the A1 biology folder, you'll then see a layout which looks very familiar, which is just folders with course content inside it. So I can have a look at lesson resources, click through, and then see in this particular instance, it is ordered by lesson, and inside that are the different resources. And at any time, you can always pop back to the mega menu, jump into a different course, and have a look in there. Let's look at using the search function in SharePoint. The search function in SharePoint is powerful, but works differently depending on where you are. If you're on the homepage, like I am here, it searches the entire site across all the SharePoint sites that you have access to. But if you're within a course, it searches just that course. So you use specific keywords to find what you need. So for example, I've typed in the word assignment here, and I'm going to click search. And because I'm in the main homepage, it will search across all of SharePoint that I have access to. And I can see there's a lot of stuff there. Now, if I want to just look specifically at one of my courses, such as biology, I can then go back and I can search for something here, and I'll see all the results now only relate to biology. A small tip, but it'll make a massive difference when you're trying to find something and you're not sure where it's located. So there we go. Now let's have a look at OneDrive. OneDrive is where you store all your personal files. Now the good thing with OneDrive and Microsoft is the files are available in the cloud, and if you're logged into a college computer, they actually also show up as your files on the computer. So this is where you keep all your files, and it's crucial to stay organized, and we're going to show you how to do that. But let's just have a quick look first at OneDrive. So here is my OneDrive here, and it has straight away, it starts to recommend documents that you might want to use, and it starts to know what you've been working on. It then shows me all my recent files, and I can filter those by Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and PDF files, and more. On the left, then I have a tab for my files. And this is where you actually then start to see your documents. So in here, I've got my documents, and I'm going to start now by creating some folders for my courses. So up on the top left here, I can see a button says add new. So here, I'm going to create a new folder. And I'm going to call this biology. And that now has created a folder called biology. I'll create another one for my other course, chemistry, and so on. And then it's really important to keep yourself organized, is then within the folder, we're going to create some subfolders for different topics or assignments. This will help you keep everything in order and easy to find. I'm just going to use some general names, but you'll need to organize your files and folders in a way that makes sense for the course you're doing. So here for biology, I'm just going to call the first one one, and I'm going to call this module one. I'll make another one, two, module two. And I might even want to create one then for homework. But what's critical is making sure that you start from the beginning with an ordered, structured system so that you know where to find things because you've put them in a sensible place. Now, from within OneDrive, under that Add New button, there's also the option to add new documents. You can start a blank Word document. So by clicking on that, it's going to begin a new Word document. And the clever thing here is it will locate it in the folder that you are presently in. So at the moment, I'm in my biology folder. So when I click a new document, that will now go into that folder. So I'm going to say, this is my biology work. Good practice. Always give your documents a sensible name. You do not want your folders to be filling up with document one, document two. You'll never find them again. So simply, once you're in OneDrive's online version of Word, you can click at the top here and you can change the file name. So I'm going to call this one cells. And then I can see here where it's saying that it's going to save, but I might want to move that. So I can click on the little arrow and it'll bring up the OneDrive interface that I'm used to. I know in my documents, and I had a biology folder, and I want to make sure that document now is in module one. So I'm going to click move here, and that will move that document inside that folder. And if I jump over to my OneDrive and have a look now, I can see this cells document, but in a moment, hopefully it will move into here. And there it is, it's moved into there. Getting organized from the outset at the beginning is absolutely vital. Get into those routines and habits. It'll make it a lot easier to find your work in the future. Lastly, let's look at the myBHASVIC app. This app is your one-stop shop for quick access to essential resources like SharePoint, CEDA, which is our student management system. For more information about that, you can check out the video here, your calendar, and your timetable. So download it on your Android or iOS device and have everything you need right at your fingertips. Open the app and explore the different sections. Use the links to access SharePoint for course material, CEDA to check your grades and attendance, and your calendar to keep track of your schedule. So as you can see on the screen here are lots of shortcuts to different important tools that you will use whilst at the college. You can use the mega menu or the hamburger menu at the top to look at all the shortcuts to different aspects of the app. And along the bottom, you have the home tab, the Canada tab, the mail tab, and the news tab. As you can see here, the Canada tab also includes information about assignments that you will have due soon. And once college is up and running, you'll see lots of information pop up in the news feed. Make sure you've got notifications turned on so that you get important information as it comes through. Well, that is it for your digital induction. You're now ready to start your journey at BHASVIC. We also have a digital induction SharePoint site, which we put in the description below, which gives you handy written guides, tutorials, and more information about the tools and systems we use at BHASVIC. Now, don't forget to keep an eye out for the digital induction assignments in Teams and get those done as soon as you possibly can. And of course, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to your teachers or the IT team. Welcome once again, and have an amazing start to your year.